So, this video is for those students who wanted to pursue computer science honors after they have passed class 12 under an affiliated college of Calcutta University. So, firstly, I want to tell you that you are studying under CBCS system, okay, where you will have to give 6 semesters. This is a 3-year course, as we all know, but each year is divided into 2 semesters, means the duration of each semester is 6 months. Duration of each semester. So duration of a year means 2 semesters is equal to 12 months. CBCS means in each paper there is some credit, some weightage assigned to that paper. Generally the credit is 6, but it varies a lot. Okay. So as computer science is a practical oriented subject, means you have to study theory as well as you have to implement those theoretical program in a practical orientation field. Okay. So out of the total marks of each paper is 100, out of which the subdivision is like this. Theory is of 50 marks, practical is of 30 marks, internal assignment or internal assessment means an exam which will be conducted by the college is of 10 marks, and attendance means you have to be present in the college classes both physically as well as mentally. See, physically only if you are present, that's of no use. You have to interact with the teacher. The student-teacher interaction must be interactive so that you can get the full 10 marks in attendance. So the total marks is 100. Okay, now as this is a 3-year course, means you have to study 6 semesters. So I will discuss the papers, the subjects which you will have to study. Okay, so the honors paper is denoted by CC, okay, means core course. Other than this, in second year and third year, you will be given an option to choose 2 additional papers or 4 additional papers, which will be dependent on the year which you are studying. So in second year, you will be studying an additional paper called SEC, means Skill Enhancement Course. And in third year, you will have to study another 2 papers, DSE, in which out of two papers, you will have to opt for only one. Its full form is Discipline Skill Elective Course. Okay, so there are 3 kinds of honors papers: core course, skill enhancement course, discipline skill elective course. So in this 3 years, you will have to study 20 honors paper in total, means the total full marks of the 3-year honors paper is 2000, means 20 papers into each of 100 marks, which comes out to be 2000, means out of 2000, the number which you will score will matter when you will go to the master's level. Okay, so coming to the first semester, you will have to study 2 honors papers only. CC1, which is the name of the paper, is Digital Electronics. Digital Electronics. And CC2 is Programming with C. Programming with C. Both has theory as well as practical papers. This is a hardware topic, this is a software topic. Okay, coming to the second semester. CC3, you will study data structures using C. CC4, analog electronics. This is the software oriented paper. This is a hardware oriented paper. You will study data structures using C. This is the CC3 paper. CC4 is analog electronics. Okay, now coming to the, so the first year curriculum is complete. First year means first semester and second semester. In first semester you will study programming with C and digital electronics, and in second semester you will study analog electronics and data structures using C. Okay, so coming to the third semester, or when you will step to the second year. Third semester, here there are three core course papers. CC5, which is computer architecture or organization and architecture rather. CC6, computational mathematics. CC7, operating system. And so there are three CC papers. First is computer organization and architecture, which is a hardware topic. CC6 is computational mathematics. In this special paper you will study like something related to mathematics, okay. And CC7 is operating system, and in all the three you have practical, and especially in operating system, in theory you will study about the operating system of computer, but in practical you will learn a new programming language, which is shell programming language, and it operates in Unix platform. Okay, now in addition, in third semester you have to study a SEC paper, which I have discussed earlier. A SEC paper, there are two options given. First is computer graphics and the second is IoT. Okay, you have to opt for only one, either computer graphics or IoT. When I was in third semester, I opted for computer graphics. Now coming to the fourth semester. Again, there are three CC papers in fourth semester. The first CC8 paper name is Computer Networks. And in practical, you will study another programming language, which is HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. Okay, CC9, Algorithms. Okay, and in practical you will implement some algorithms using C programming language, which we have studied in the last three semesters. Okay, and CC10 is microprocessor and its applications. Mainly you will study about 8085 and 8086. And you will also study something about microcontrollers, but the paper name is microprocessor. Okay, so in microprocessor is a hardware oriented topic where you will be given a kit, microprocessor kit, and you have to implement some of mathematical operations using another programming language, which is nothing but assembly programming language. See, C, C++, Java, Python, we all know these are high level programming language, but the practical of microprocessor is implemented using assembly programming language. Okay, and in addition, with these three CC papers, you will study another SEC paper, where again you will be given two choices out of which you will study only one. Okay, first choice is e-commerce and the second choice is information security. When I was in fourth semester, I studied e-commerce because I think it's an interesting topic, so I opted for e-commerce. And another thing which must be kept in mind, that this SEC paper has only theory part, it has no practical part, only theory part, which is of 80 marks both in third semester and fourth semester. The SEC paper is of 80 marks as there is no practical. Now I think you have completed the second year also. Now we will switch to the fifth semester. Fifth semester. In fifth semester, you will study two CC papers. CC 11, which is Database Management System or DBMS. And in practical, you will learn MySQL and PHP. Okay? CC 12, we will study about Java programming language, and its practical is to implement some programs using Java programming language. And in theory, we will study about the theory of Java. Okay, I think it's quite interesting. And there are now, there are two CC papers which we have discussed. Now there are two DSC papers. Earlier we have discussed about DSC, that DSC stands for Discipline Skill Elective Course. So there are two DSC papers, DSC A 1. One is Digital Image Processing. Digital Image Processing. And this is Data Mining. When I was in fifth semester, I opted for studying Digital Image Processing because the reason is, I am telling with everyone, in third semester we have studied computer graphics. I have studied computer graphics. So computer graphics and digital image processing has many similarities. So I opted for digital image processing when I was in fifth semester. You can study data mining also, is up to your choice, but I opted for digital image processing. Okay, now DSC B, again it has two topics out of which you have to study one. The first topic is operational research and the second topic is Python. When I was in fifth semester, I opted for operational research because I had some interest in mathematics to solve LPP problems. This is nothing but LPP. I had an interest with linear programming problems like transportation problems, simplex problems and graphical problems. So I opted for LPP when I was in fifth semester. I opted for DSC B, operational research. Okay, you can opt for Python also if you have a deep interest in Python. It's up to your choice. Now coming to the last semester or the sixth semester. And another thing, both DSC papers has practicals. It is a practical oriented paper. Sixth semester. So again it has two CC papers, CC 13 and CC 14. CC 13 is, and CC 14, right, and DSC A another and DSC B another. Okay, so CC 13, which we have studied, the core course 13 or the last core course which we have studied is Software Engineering. It is only theory based subject, it has no practical. and CC14 is theory of computation or automata, and CC14 has a practical which comes under a project, means we have to design or we have to make something new so that we can get good marks. We have to do a project work. When I was in the last semester or sixth semester, we have worked on a college making website. Like whenever you are filling a form in college, what comes? Application page, registration page, payment page, and etc. So we have tried to make a same project or the same thing like website designing, and we have successfully done with HTML, CSS, Bootstrap, JavaScript and many things. So we can do other projects also, which in when you will go to the sixth semester, you will discuss with your teachers that what project will you do. But the main thing is that CC14 you will study when you will do something new, means you will do project work, and CC13 is of 70 marks and CC14 is of 130 marks. Okay, now again you will study two DSE papers. DSE A, 3 is embedded system, which is again a hardware topic, and 4 is multimedia, and it's applications. Okay, when I was in sixth semester, I opted for this paper, multimedia and its applications. Okay, now coming to the DSE B topic, and the papers are introduction to computational intelligence or artificial intelligence, but the paper name is computational intelligence, or in addition you can write CI, and this is advanced java. So there are two papers, computational intelligence and advanced java. You have to opt for only one, either computational intelligence or advanced java. When I was a sixth semester, I opted for this paper, computational intelligence. So I think you all have understood the papers, what topics will you study, both hardware topics as well as software topics. I think it's very, very interesting. I enjoyed a lot in my 3 years. I enjoyed a lot while studying each paper. Each paper has many more things which you will get to know about the topic, like in electronics or digital image processing or computational intelligence, advanced Java, multimedia, whichever topic is very interesting. Secure good marks. Wish you a very good luck.